the day without your smile. Another day just passes by. But now I know how much it means for you to stay right here with me. The time we spend apart will make our love grow stronger, but it hurts so bad I can't take it any longer. I wanna go home with you. I wanna die lying in your arms. I wanna grow old with you. I wanna be looking in your eyes. I wanna be there for you, sharing in everything you do.
I never knew what love could do to a heart that is surrendered. Found out the truth when I met you. Now my heart is yours forever. You're the one I wanna dance with for the rest of my life. You're the one I wanna hold and never let go. Without you I'd be lonely. Without you I'd be lost. I need you by my side for the rest of my life. Without you, I'd be lonely. Without you, I'd be weak. I need your love till death do us part. Can
we have been waiting for hearts to arrive finally? Yeah, just had the triumphant entry of the bride and the gentleman who has escorted her. She now is on the arm of the groom and smiling radiantly. Welcome to this momentous occasion, the fulfillment of a dream that been cherished for years now by Romaine and Nerissa. And we are privileged and blessed to be part of the unfolding of this occasion. So welcome, and we are happy to be with them. It's an honor to officiate Romaine and Nerissa at your marriage ceremony. God is with us, and I should let you know that we'll have some minor variation to the ceremony in terms of the outline of the events, the sequence they, which they will take place. So we are going to blend our voices in singing familiar song usually employed on occasion like this, "O Perfect Love." And that's what the couple has experience, and they have come to solemnize that love today in holy matrimony. If you have your advent, your device, it's 654, "O Perfect Love." Now, I'm not as gifted as some of you are making melodious sounds. So those are persons so gifted, we ask you to strike the note for us, "O Perfect Love," all human, all transcending.
I just want to sing it.
see. Okay. A songster is going to give us a rendition of the opening hymn, O Perfect Love.
O perfect love, all human thoughts transcending, lowly we kneel in prayer before thy throne, that there may be the love which knows no ending, whom thou forevermore dost join in one. O perfect life, be thou their full assurance of tender charity and steadfast faith, of patient hope and quiet brave endurance, which I like trust that fears no pain nor death, and grant them the joy which brightens earthly sorrow, grant them the peace which calm all earthly strife, and to life's day the glorious unknown morrow that dawns upon eternal love and light.
Thank you. Well done. The third stanza is a prayer invoking God's blessings upon the couple. Grant them the joy that brightens earthly sorrow. Romina Nerissa, the author of this song, somehow had you in mind, couples like you, when the song was penned. The next line says, grant them the peace that calms all earthly strife. That's peace sublime from the Father of peace. And finally, add to life's day the glorious unknown morrow that dawns upon eternal love and life. The author has eternity in mind and wants to experience the bliss that eternity will bring for the redeemed. And invite us to bow our heads as we invoke God's presence in our meet ceremony this afternoon. Shall we pray? Father in heaven, truly, your love for us in many different ways have been demonstrated to us. And Lord, on this occasion, especially in the gift of holy matrimony to the human race, and at this occasion, it's a gift to Romaine and Nerissa. We thank you, Lord, on their behalf. And they, no doubt, in their hearts, silently expressing their thanks and gratitude to you, loving Father, for this blessed gift to them. We now embark on this marriage ceremony. And Lord, we ask you to be the chief officiating personnel that is to recognize your supreme in their life. And they are now being formed marriage union. Lord, bless Romaine and Nerissa. Bless the members of the bridal party and all those at this time, give them their support. We pray thanks in your son's name. Amen. Amen. Audience, be seated, please. The person assigned to give out the scripture reading will now come and do so.
Scripture reading is taken from Genesis 2, verses 18 through to 24, and it reads thus, and the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him an helpmeet for him. And out of the ground the Lord formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air, and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. And Adam gave names to all cattle, and to the fowl of the air, and to the beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found an helpmeet for him. And the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept, and he took one of his ribs, and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the ribs which the Lord God had taken from man made he a woman, and he brought her unto the man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. 24 and last, therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Here ends a portion of God's holy word.
Amen. Thank you. I'm sure you heard loud and clear. Okay. In the passage just read, we have the revelation to us of the making of the first woman. Interestingly, and very importantly, and most importantly, Romaine, she was taken from the rib of the man. And that says that she's a part of him. And Adam walks lyrical, poetical, when he said, she is bone of my bone, the flesh of my flesh. And that's what we want to think yes in your heart this afternoon, Romaine. Bone of your bone and flesh of your flesh. And that carries a special message that she must be treated with the greatest of respect. The Bible says in Ephesians 5, no man yet ever hated his own flesh, but love and cherish it. And so, she is your flesh, your bone, to be loved and cherished in the greatest of way. And Nerissa, the first wife, comes from the verse. And by implication, that had you in mind, because you're not becoming what Eve became to Adam, his wife, his beloved wife, a charming, gorgeous woman she was. And likewise is a lady who now has her hand in yours. And it tells us that, remember the audience, is a man with discerning eyes, is a man with taste. He has chosen someone reminiscent of Eve, which God gave to his son Adam. God has given to you, Romaine, his daughter, Nerissa, to be your wife. And marriage vow says, until death do us part. Right? She was meant, basically she was taken from his rib, under his arm, to be protected by him. You are to be Nerissa's protector. That is, if danger should appear, then unlike that other man who put his wife in front of him, you will step in front and defend her. That's what real men do. Okay? You are to be her protector. She is to be provide leadership. Head, provide leadership. And she's your equal. It's taken from you, that inferior. your partners in marriage, and they're going to work on it even more than you would have been doing during your years of courtship. Therefore, shall man leave his father and his mother. Man here is meant to mean a grown man, sensible, responsible, can reason and make wise decision. One who will have conversation with his wife when addressing issues that will emerge inevitable in a marriage union, knowing that she too has a brain like, you do. So you will allow her to make her input. I'm sure that she would have proven that during the years you have been together, you would have had issues to deal with, and together would have sat down and would have reasoned those issues out, and mutually you would have made decisions that would have helped to blend your relationship to the extent where you are now standing here in God's presence and us as witnesses to unite your lives into one. The Bible says, therefore shall man leave his father and his mother and shall cleave unto his wife. Cleaving means blending, being welded together, cohesiveness, everything like that, become one. Unity is something mysterious. We can explain it, but with God, all things are possible. And so we're happy for you, Romain and Nerissa. And God bless you as you go forth to practice what is in the inspired word of God. Who gave this lovely lady to be married to this handsome gentleman? He raises his hand in affirmation. Thank you, sir. Your task has been accomplished. You can have your seat now. Okay, so we're going to ask Romain and Nerissa to face each other. And this is the moment when mutually they will share. You're going to write and to write, and you want to, or really have the bouquet, please. So I'm going to, okay, come closer, please. It's about oneness. You know the Bible says they're becoming one. So get closer and closer and closer till you. Okay. Romain, you will go first. And then Nerissa will reciprocate. Okay. I'm going to. It's symbolic of the togetherness and the oneness and everything like that that they intend to have as they go forward from here. I pray God will indeed unite them as one, that they be an exemplary marriage couple. Now, Romain, you're going to, when I'm finished, you're going to say, I do. Okay. Don't look at me, look at Nerissa. And she will look at you. All right, as you clasp your hands in hers. Will you, Romain Denver Rodney, do you take this woman you clasp by the hand to be a lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Heard him? Yes, the real man does. You're not finished yet, Romain. I'll continue. That's the first step. The major step will now be done. You're going to repeat. You will say after me, I do. Do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses to be to her a faithful, loving husband in sunshine or in shadow, in gain or in loss, in trial or in triumph, and keep yourself only unto her, that's unto Nerissa Natasha Campbell. So long as you both shall live, according to God's holy ordinance, do you so declare?
I do.
Thank you, sir. Nerissa, you will not reciprocate. It's mutual. Okay. See, Judge Justin are here. Caring, tenderness. Well, let's continue. Will you, Nerissa, Natasha, Campbell, do you take this man, Romaine Denver Rodney, you class by the hand to be a lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
The lovely feminine voice. You continue, Nerissa. Will you, Nerissa, Natasha, Campbell, do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses to be to him a faithful, loving wife in sunshine or in shadow, in gain or in loss? That means there is some other plenty money or not. Love him just the same. In trial or in triumph. And note what comes next, Nerissa. And keep yourself only unto him. So there's no greener grass over the fence. So long as you both shall live, according to God's holy ordinance, do you so declare?
I do.
Thank you. Go, put your right hand. Okay. In as much as you, Romaine Denver Rodney, and Nerissa Natasha Campbell, have taken these pledges of affection and vows of fidelity, I, a minister of the gospel, been authorized by the word of God, by the law of Jamaica, hereby pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. And invite the couple to join me kneeling while I pronounce a prayer of dedication. They continue holding right hand. Oh, that will come. Please kneel. And when by the audience will join us in prayer, you bow your heads reverently, close your eyes, and in your heart inaudible, you utter prayer to God on their behalf. Let us pray. Our great God and almighty Father, God of love and all goodness, this afternoon, based on the authorization of your holy word, we bend our knees in your presence, thanking you for your matchless love. That love, Lord, which you have in your heart, has been instilled in the hearts of Romaine and Nerissa. And now, Lord, they have come kneeling before you, pledging to you that they will fulfill the sacred pledges or vows they both have taken in your presence and ours also. We pray, mighty God, that as the originator of marriage, you will day by day aid them in building a noble, harmonious, happy, and productive marriage relationship. We place into your hands, Lord, Romaine. Let him be a God-fearing husband. One will increasingly love his wife regardless of the circumstances that they will encounter as they proceed from here in life. May he seek, Lord, unite his life with yours so that you can guide him to be a responsible, loving, forgiving, and loyal husband. Grant him intellectual might and physical strength to work with his wife to ensure the success of their marriage union. May Nerissa, Lord, be that virtuous wife your word speaks about in Proverbs. May she be a God-fearing wife, who in the first place be loyal to you, and secondly to her husband, Romaine. May Sheila be a woman of prayer, who will intercede on their behalf, so they can be blended by your grace as one, and the life they live will be an exemplary one that inspire others to do similarly. Help her, Lord, to be there for him always. May they understand that oneness must be an important stone in their marriage union. Let there be understanding. Let there be wisdom of heavenly character that will help them, Lord, to make decisions that will enhance their marriage union. Thank you for all those who have come today to share with them on this grand glorious occasion. Bless each man the bridal party. Bless each participant in this marriage ceremony this afternoon. Lord, that they shall leave it for the place of reception. Go with them, grant and join the mercies. And may they have a wonderful time. And we pray, mighty God, that they will both make up their mind to unite their life with yours in spiritual marriage. So you can be husband to them both. They can be part of your bride, your church. So when you shall come, they shall be among our faithful couples of this world. On that great and glorious day, mighty God, we go home to spend eternity with you. We pray and say thanks. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the audience say, amen. 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 Please rise. Good, good. Okay, we have had the first segment of the ceremony. Next segment go by the table where the couple will sign and their two witnesses, the best man and the chief bridesmaid. Then we'll come back and we'll do the other thing that you're expecting eagerly to be done, among other things, right? So, Mr. Rodney, you know, Mr. Rodney, you know, married man. Mr. Rodney is going to perform his first duty of the being married, going to escort his wife to the table. You seat her on the left chair. You will sit on the right, okay?
Tide are rolling by like thunder now as I look in your eyes. I hold on to your body and feel each move you make. Your voice is warm and tender, love that I could not forsake. 'Cause I'm your lady,
to take, that I'll answer when I'm with you. Even though there may be times, it seems I'm far away.
Near,
one time and last for a lifetime and never let go till we're gone. Love was when I loved you one true time. I hold you in my life, will always go on.
I set out on a long road way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost a time or two, wiped my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. And every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, and they were like northern stars, pointing me on my way into your loving arm. This much I know is true, that God blessed the broken road that led me straight to you. I think about the years I've spent just passing through. I'd like to have the time I lost and give it back to you. But you just smile and take my hand. You've been there, you understand. It's all part of a grander plan that is coming true. And every long lost dream led me into your arms. And others may walk my heart, and there are like northern stars, pointing me on my way into your loving arms. This much I know is true, that God blessed this broken road that led me straight to you. And every long lost dream led me to you. Others who broke my heart, they were like northern stars, pointing me on my way into your loving arms. This much I know is true, that God bless this broken road that led me straight to you. That God bless this broken road that led me straight to you.
My eyes when I couldn't.
Says also that God is supreme. And we thank God for them both. I extend to you my heartiest congratulations. I have in my hand a brown envelope. In it is a copy of the bridal register of marriage. Their copy. And they both affixed their signatures to it along with their two witnesses. Right? And in the legal sense, but before that, morally, because we had the spiritual segment of the ceremony, right, the religious component, spiritual component. It says, sir, that this lady is your lawfully wedded wife. She belongs to you exclusively. And there is, so this gentleman doesn't look handsome. And he gets more handsome now. Is your right, lawfully wedded husband. He's yours exclusively. And when you see him, you own him. No one dare challenge you. Applaud them, please. I have to present to them their certificate of marriage. It says that they belong to each other. The twin have become one. See about. Put your hands here. Congratulations, sir. Congratulations, lady. Loveless look. So photographer, yes, he's shooting away. So they have their formally licensed. They are legitimate now. They have access to all the privileges of marriage, uninhibited. No one dare question them anymore. You're following me, right? And so, you know what now? They'll give us a live and direct demonstration how they are going to, oh, Somebody jump in the God. I won't tell you who, you know who. All right, they have some items of jewelry they're going to give to each other. So going to relieve Nerissa of the bouquet, please. Thank you. Now she's going to display the right hand. The right hand here carry a special meaning. The right hand with the right finger and which are how we place the marriage band. Show us that hand. In this case, which hand is it? This one. Left. Yes. The left hand is the right hand at this side. That's what I'm saying, right? Okay, ready? Who has the wedding ring? Who has the ring? Open it. Will you take it out, sir? And raise the hand. From which finger, Nerissa, which finger is it? Oh, she's indicating by. Go ahead now. Go ahead. Oh, yes.
No rush.
Oh, yes. Firmly in place. Nerissa, how does it feel?
It's okay. It feels great.
Great. And somebody says something, but later will be something, won't tell you. Nerissa, where is her? Give it to Nerissa. She's going to reciprocate. Go ahead, Nerissa. Take it out. I'm going to walk in the wife's footsteps. But for no exam, she has just said, all right, there it is. She's putting it in place. It's mutual, you know. So in this thing, they assist each other. And this is symbolic. Right? She's working it on. I said working it on. It has gone as far as it can go. Is it Bok? Okay. He's giving some instruction. And he's patiently allowing her to do what she has to do. All right. Okay, fine. Beautiful. It's a good sister. You see it? Two became one. Working together. Teamwork. Good. It's settled. Okay. All right. When you demonstrate to the audience, show them, demonstrate the audience. Just show off. You're going to show off. Turn around. All right. Now, put your hands up together and raise your hands and show them. Okay. Okay. Now, make sure they have strong hearts now. Right? They know what is meant. They know what is meant. Right? You've never, sir. These pretty ladies, put that finger up.
Yes, Buster. Get ready.
Prep. I'm going to take your position now. I'm going to take your position. Wait. Construction. We're going to court dog, right? All right. I won't keep them waiting any longer. Three. We're doing it quickly. 2 3/4. Three. It's your turn, though. All right. This can. I mean, that was rehearsal. This was a rehearsal. So give them the brother.
Yes, man.
All right, make sure you're ready now.
Thank you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, will you stand to your feet, please, and give the couple that special round of applause, okay? Go ahead. We thank the Lord God for being with us to this ceremony this afternoon, and just imagine your mind what it was like when God presided over the first marriage in Eden. He was the first marriage officer before that he performed a surgical procedure when he took away from Adam and made Eve. And remain, you don't have your rib, right? Fully, completely, perfectly. Okay, we're going to have the recessional, and the audience will greet you on the outside. All right. Gonna ask the bridal party from Archie's. Okay. Best gentlemen and ladies from the Archie's. And they will in benches. What if I'll trip you? Go down.
Glam, everybody said. This is a safety.
Yes, right.
Mm-hmm. All the way, remember, see the one in the right hand.
Archie. Mm-hmm. You want to go down? Go down somewhere. Go down somewhere. In the aisle.
Anyway, we can walk. My take.
Okay.
From this moment, life has begun. From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment on, from this moment I have been blessed. I live only for your happiness and for your love. I'd give my last breath. From this moment on, I give my hand to you with all my heart. I can't wait to live my life with you. I can't wait to start. You and I will never be apart. My dreams came true. From this moment,
Today only, Mr. Garrett Armstrong. They were prepared.
Sabi girl no dey too like talk.
That's it.
Animals dey in human form. Body man nobody like walk. But you must hustle if you want job. You no finish them
on fight us.
If them dey run them no fit catch up. I know they form say I too
that's
like
it.
Us. No con dey form say you too
that's
like
that's it America us. Show him.
You get the time for the hate and the bad energy. Come my mind on my money. Make you dance like Bokoli.
You go, girl. I guess that's why she's called Mrs. She knows how it's done. All right. Now, ladies and gentlemen, because the money is water so good, you have to go stand up on your foot. Yes. May we all stand to the grandest entrance of the evening. We have... I want you to practice the clapping so they can feel all the need to walk in merrier. Clap no. Clap them no. Clap them no. Is it a special song for the newlyweds? That's it? Okay. Pull up selector. The song bad them have start it over. And the one Evan him ready, you know, man. Watch him, watch him, watch him, watch him. Pure teeth and lips. All right, we're going to make room for them because what I've been told is that this entrance is grander than the rest. So we have to make way. And I've been watching the bride, you know. One artist would say trouble the day. Just give them something, man. Something nice.
Trouble.
Ladies and gentlemen, the couple of the hour we have entering at this time, Mr. and Mrs. Romaine Rodney. Clap them up. I want you to say, wife, that's it. Show them. Show them.
You wear the ring.
All right, Rodney, your time now. Mr. Rodney, your time now. One hand, man.
Feel my fat up your purse. All them attack, girl, make them fret. I don't know you are your man. You are fame choice.
Clap them on.
You come first. Wife, you my fat up your purse. All them attack, girl,
make them fret.
Cause you don't know you why your man not left. You a fame choice, fame first prize. Jump and shout out, girl, you are the wife.
Whoa. She is wife indeed. Let's give them another round and round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
But your man make them fret. Girl, a puss up. She not ready yet.
No man. This bride is on fire. Let me hear you say hot, hot, hot. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, they're looking gorgeous. I'm going to ask that the men, the groomsmen. Groomsmen, you ready for me? You're just going to turn your chair over. Turn your chairs over for the other two that's on, that's not yet but been put on foot. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to give you 10 seconds. And I've never done this at another event. But because we can put so many things in the mix, I'm going to ask from where you're seated to just say a word of blessing in your own way. Put your hand forward, and I want you to bless the bridal party. You don't have to speak loudly. Your neighbor don't have to hear what you have said, but just offer a word of blessing before they are seated in your own way. Send them your blessings, especially Mr. and Mrs. Remain Rodney. Giving you a minute. That's our minute. We're going to ask that these beautiful people feel comfortable in taking their seats. I know it's been a long day. You may all go ahead and be seated. There was an arrangement. Oh, hold on. Let me hear what the plan was. All right, there was an arrangement, so we're going to allow the gentlemen to do what they do best. Trevor just well want the moment for seat one young lady. Watch him. Well want seat one young lady. Pause the show. He's supposed to seat the ladies. I like him. Sounds like a gentleman. Don't clap, Trevor, man. Thank you so much. Me can't ever call him Trevor no more. With such behavior, I have to call him Mr. Brown. No Trevor up here today. Mr. Brown. I see Mr. Brown is following in Mr. Rodney's footsteps. That's nice. And Bunting is down there smiling because he have plans up him sleeve, you know, but the night young. So I'm not sure where I'm going to do yet, but we're waiting for it. All right, but, all right, sir? All right. Up, up, up. All right, we're going to take the music a little bit low. And if you are following your program, it would have said that I bring you welcome. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is an esteemed pleasure for me to be here this evening at this memorable occasion. And even more esteemed to have been given the task as your master of ceremony for this event. Now, it is projected to be a wonderful spent remainder of the evening for us. I know who will enjoy the latter part of the night. I can tell you it's not us, but it is a wonderful evening. Would you agree with me? It is. And this afternoon when I came to the church and I saw what a small gathering it was, I was saying to myself, I think this is going to turn out good. Because sometimes the smaller the gathering, the more intimate and meaningful the occasion. We're a small family and we are grateful for such an occasion where two families can come together for a greater good. A man has chosen a woman this afternoon in this little facility, at this time, at this place right now, and he has decided to take her as his legally lawful wedded. Call the word for me, no? Clap him. Secondly, in my welcome, I want you all to clap yourselves because you could have chosen to be anywhere else. But you have decided to share in a wondrous occasion. So clap yourselves. And I must say, you're all looking elegant. From where I'm standing, you're all looking so beautiful. You see all my good auntie them in a them shimmer dress? If current gone tonight, we good. We have light. You see that bright smile that Mrs. Rodney's wearing? If current gone tonight, we good. So many things are beaming and we are blessed and highly favored to be here. Clap yourselves again. Now, on behalf of the newlyweds and on their behalf, I want to say they are very delighted to have us here this afternoon. And for those who could not make it, I don't know if I feel good or bad about this, but for those who could not make it, we will be missing them. I'm sure there are persons who would have wanted to be here, and some who are here in spirit, and we are going to miss them, but Me not so much, because it only means that I only get more food and more cake and souvenir and that little type of thing. There's a popular saying that say, I don't know if you know this song. When you go to school, teacher always sing it. It's love, it's love, it's love that makes. You know that song? Sing it for me. It's love that makes the world go round. But I want to put a little twist to it tonight. Because while the world goes round, I want to add that it is love that makes the ride worthwhile. Because to be honest, whether there's love or hate, the world still what? Still turn, love or not. But once you have love in it, it makes the journey all the more worthwhile. All praises be to God for great things he has done. For this evening, we are witnesses of the fruition of true love, where Mr. and Mrs. Romaine Rodney have decided to take this worthwhile journey together. Ladies and gentlemen, let us give them another rousing round of applause for the newlyweds again. And while I still have time, I want to let the newlyweds know that we won't be the only ones clapping hands right through this evening. And as such, we the guests are looking forward to the clapping of lips from you both, as whenever we demand it, because we in charge, and with the sound of cheers of love. So anytime we utter the word love, what are they to do? And Missy Odema practice. Uno sit, don't it? At one point I was saying, I bet there no capture, no picture without no kiss. Every picture kiss. Every picture kiss. Watch Mr. Rodney. Every picture kiss, don't it? Mrs. Rodney not nah, say nothing. She just go and drink her soup. Yeah. There was love. Miss Sarfio, all when the selector start play pure love song, I hear love. Somebody have to go borrow lips. Somebody said love. 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 Watch love. What? No. That love going to lead to baby. Let's go. It's love. It's love that makes this couple smile, and Mr. Rodney's beaming. It's love. They said two antennas met on a roof. Listen to me now. Two antennas. You know, antenna, then two look to stick something there behind some big back TV. We don't see them so often no more, but the older folks would have known what I'm talking about. The two antennas. Yeah, you have to set them good on one person. You have to stand up outside and say, it a show now? And somebody say, no, turn it. What are you just? No, you got the two antennas something there, yes. You know it. Two antennas met on a roof. All right? Them are the two antennas. They fell in love and they got married. The ceremony wasn't much, but the reception was excellent. And with that said, ladies and gentlemen, we're looking forward to a wonderful reception and a wonderful rest of the evening. And as your program would have told you, at this point, we are getting ready for the blessing of the cake and the good food I'm just talking about, and the dinner. And to do that, to be blessing the cake this afternoon, and of course the scrumptious dinner that is on its way, we have no other than Mrs. Michelle Smith Taylor. Is she here? Okay, she's coming in her beautiful red dress, walking so elegantly. Can you clap her while she comes? Yes, man, clap her.
Good afternoon, everyone. Let me add my quote of congratulations to the couple just before I pray. Good step. May God continue to guide and to bless you. Let us assume the attitude of prayer everywhere as we talk to our Father in heaven. Gracious, almighty God, we are truly honored. We are happy. We are privileged to be here on this solemn occasion. We want to thank you for journeying mercies from morning until now. Thank you for all that you've done for every single person, especially the couple of the moment. Lord, we place before you the meals that will be received. Various the ingredients in both of them, the food and the cake. And mighty God, they were provided from resources. We pray this afternoon that you will multiply the resources. We pray that you will rain down your blessings on the pockets. Father, we pray that the persons that provide, that prepare them, that you will touch them likewise. And as they continue to do what they do, help them to remember, dear God, that all blessings come from you. So, Father, we thank you. May you add your special love to every piece of the cake, every piece of the food that will be received, mighty God. Purify it, sanctify them, that as we receive them, Father, they will be filling. May you continue to bless us as we continue to look to you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you so much, Mrs. Michelle Smith Taylor. Well said. How are you feeling? Feel good? If you feel good, let me hear you say good. If you feel good, let me hear you say better. If you feel good, let me hear you say best. Good, better, best. And may, just like our feelings, Mr. and Mrs. Rodney's feelings, continue to grow for one another. It has been a very emotional day. I don't see no tears yet. I saw the bride shedding some tears of love earlier in the church. Is that so? Or something got in her eye? She was shedding some tears of joy. Is that so, Mrs. Rodney? It has been a very emotional day. And as some of you may have noticed, even the cake has tears. Everybody, they look upon the cake now. I just wanted to mention that the cake was looking very good. You see these beautiful peach blossoming, is it rose? Rose petals. Clap the cake. Cake look good. Yes, man, the cake look good. Now, it says here that we should be having dinner. I know most of us are hungry. Some are still eating their soup. Let me find out if there was a specific. I am going to be finding out just how we are going to be doing the dinner. I know everybody would have placed their orders, correct? Yes, anybody in here have not given their order as yet? All right, one person. So we're going to get the gentleman to come and take your order. All right, so in the meantime, we're going to enjoy some music, and I'll go and find out if you will be served or what is the official arrangement. In the same time, I want you to just look at the couple and enjoy yourselves. All right? Just give me a quick second. I won't be a secret love, 'cause it's just a waste of my life. I'm telling you from the start, I won't be the one who gives you love when you're all alone. I was just informed that you will be served by a table, and to make the decision as to which table gets served first, well, we know it is the head table that gets served first, but otherwise from them, we're going to run a quick competition to see who gets served first. Now, I have written down Miss Music Lady, sorry, Chumi used to man, hush, but to see which table gets served first. I have here some very popular love song that you always hear at wedding. I'm assuming that everybody has been to a wedding before, right? Anybody in here for the first time? First time attending a wedding? First time she attending a wedding and she have on wedding ring. I can't understand that one. Anybody in here for the first time? First time coming to wedding? And you married? No, man. Mm-mm. Now I'm going to give you the first line of the song. And you have to pick up where I leave off. Ready? Wedding time karaoke. Ready? While the food come. All right? And the quicker you know your lyrics, the quicker the food come. Watch magic. Table, I don't know which number this is, but I'll say that table with the rosy-looking, mature women. When I need you. You have to give the table a chance. Your son hungry over there, so them ready for singing, oh man. When I need you. When I need you. Oh man, no one help. When we have a singer. When I need you.
Open eyes and I touch you.
All right, then can't get served, don't it? All right, all right, all right. Never seen you looking so lovely as you did tonight.
Never you shine so bright.
Them can't get served too. Wise men say, who's going?
Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you.
Mr. Server, 4 plates of food for everybody over here, so them ready. All right, this table now with my handsome uncle.
My love, there's only you in my life. There's only one thing.
No, no. How much plate she must get? 2 or 1? 1 plate? All right. 2 plates? Them a big fear. All right. This table now. Looks like we've made it.
Look how far we've come, my baby. Looked a long way. Feel it till we get there somewhere. They say I'm playing. Let's look at the sun with now.
If you ever see my look and I look on the phone. But him can't get food, don't it? All right, this table now.
When a man loves a woman.
How much plate of food he must get? 3 food? 6 plate? 5? 6 plate? Yes. Sometimes, no man, if you clap him again. Clap him again for true, true, true. May I tell you, all along I didn't know that Percy Sledge was in here. All the walk me a walk on a go on like is a normal wedding. It's a big time wedding. We have celebrity over here, so without even words, he represented. Let's see how ready this table is.
Have I told you lately that I love you? That I told you. There's no one else above you.
So tell your husband, no?
Fill my life with gladness. Take away all my sadness. Even though you're sick, oh my God. That's what...
Boy, I thought when we reached that Percy Sledge, with the place mash up. But then here comes along my good, nice, clean skin, ever-looking, youthful, good, good dressmaker auntie. And she just grabbed the mic like she did a countdown for me reach over your center. And she just sing out. And then she started to show the younger couples just how it is done. Clap me, auntie. We've done all the tables. Or we can give one bonus. Oh, Lord of mercy. Man in the bright yellow. Look at this face. I know the years are showing.
Look at this life, don't you?
That sound like a vegetable alone, if you get. Look at this face. I know the years are showing.
Look at this life. Don't know.
It's going. I don't know much, but I know I love you. That may be all I need to know. Just like that. Simple, but nice. Now, I heard that the bride has a special item. I never did that table. After my auntie come and take the show, what do you mean you never know the table? Oh, you want, she think, no, I guess what she's saying is you sounded so good. She want to hear again. Oh, she want to sing. Oh, the song was so nice. Me no know. Well, on the man, let me carry the mic, because like she just wake. We're waiting on the dinner, but I'm sure you are patient enough because... You ready? She says she want to hear you now. Any song you want to sing, Jesus love me. Hello, the first thing that matters here is Jesus' love. Jesus loves me.
Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Yes, Jesus loved me. Yes, Jesus loved me. Yes, Jesus loved me. The Bible tells me so.
The best song from that. Wanna clap hard for me, no man? But guess what? Mr. and Mrs. Rodney drop off a shape because the amount of time I hear should they sing, yes, Jesus, love me this. And all know me not see the love of God on the table, what they're going up myself. The love, the love, the love, the love. Bunting. Bunting. Sanchez, them say I must call him tonight because he's in a dapper suit. No Bunting. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you enjoyed the singing just now. We don't have no real artists, but we have our own artists among us. Now, it is time for the unveiling of the beautiful cake that we spoke of earlier. And to be doing that, we have employed two mature ladies. Now, this is how they were selected. We had sent out a bulletin, and we asked for two mature ladies who were related to the married couple. We asked that these two ladies would have worked with the married couple in time gone. We asked that these two ladies had a high level of stamina, that they would have worked with the married couple for 135 hours, unlimited time, 24 hours a day, 7 days per week. They would have taken no break while encountering the married couple. Lunchtime is whenever the client decides, and they suited all the description. They must have a degree in medicine, finance, counseling, culinary arts, must be able to wear several hats, and they must have high tolerance. They must be able to put their client above themselves, and they must be able to work through the night in a chaotic environment. And the only persons that we could have founded that suits all the description was no other than the mothers off the beautiful couple. Let us give our hands, put our hands together as we ask both mothers, you have done a job that nobody else on the face of this earth could do, right? And we're asking you both to make your way here. I don't know if you want some assistance. I can get two nice gentlemen to come and pull out the chair for you, you know. Would you want that or you're good on your own? She said it's okay. Clap them, no man, as they come. Somebody would...
For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy.
Now, at the count of three, we'll be having the mothers of the beautiful couple unveil the beautiful cake that we have been waiting to see. And they are ready, and they're standing in position. My Aunt Nelly has been waiting for this moment, and it's here. All right, so after the count of three, that's one. You can just take your time and lift it up. Two, two and a half. Auntie Nelly shaking, nervous. And three. All right, it's beautiful. Put your hands together for this lovely cake. Now we're going to admire it for a little second. Miss Music Lady, could you give us a little music?
You gave me wings and made me fly. You touched my hand, I could touch the sky. I lost my faith, you gave it back to me. You said no star was out of reach. We stood by.
And at this moment, we're going to be asking Mr. and Mrs. Rodney. Oh, they're about to eat. I would ask of you to just cut a piece of the cake as a little appetizer, and then you can go back to your meal. Because Evan has been practicing how to do it the bird way, and we don't want to mess up him lips with the curry yet. We want to mess it up with the icing first. And so he's going to help his beautiful bride. No, man, no, leave your husband. Hold on upon him. Hey, take your time. Ladies and gentlemen, now as they say, the man is the head of the household, and I wonder if you know what the woman is. The woman is the what? No, man, the man is the head, and the wife is the neck. The rest, my auntie said the rest of the body. So the woman take care of the head. Children, cover up your ears. What did you say again? She takes care of the head to ensure that the head keeps straight. So it means that if he want to look to east, she know if he turn, if he make sure same head keep. And if him want to look to west, she must not turn. She must make sure him head keep. Please take up the knife and put it straight in the cake. Practice the straightness. Now, Mr. Rodney has placed his awesome, lovely, leather-like fingers on the tip of this golden, sparkly, platinum-looking long, sharp knife. And Mrs. Rodney is going to be guiding the head, but this time she's guiding his hands. And you must learn to guide him hands. Is what's so funny down there, sir? Sure. And you're going to insert the knife till you feel the base of the cake. No, don't lean it to no. Straight. Remember that she said straight. No, man, don't lean it yet. Straight. It's down. You feel the base of the cake. You're feeling the base of the cake, sir? You say feel the base of the cake. Long time. You can't wait for cut. Mm-hmm. Anyhow, by the way, we're still talking about the cake. Because I see some bright smell. And me never see nobody smell so yet if you talk about cake. So, after three, I must tell you that your ring looks gorgeous. Both of them, they do. Looks lovely over the cake. I hope the cameraman is getting some wonderful pics here. Is he nervous? Make sure Saint Olet. Straight. If him a shake, straighten him hand. All right? And after three, one, two and a quarter, two and three quarter, and three takes it down. Boy, I'm jingle sack. All the way down to the base. Direct him hand, don't take up your hand. Take it from me. Don't ever take up your hand. All the way down. Okay. All right. Now, Mr. Rodney, we have seen you kissing your wife all evening. We want to see you do something else now. We see the kiss. We know say the kiss, you have that lack. But we want to know if you can do what a real man does. Because they say otherwise from being the head of the home, he has to feed his family. He must be a provider. And tonight we help you out because we provide the cake. So all you have to show we know is how you plan to feed your wife. Boy, she hold the knife straight. Them a coordinate. All right, plan out how to go do it. Pardon? You go cut it out, man. You can tell her to take a rest. All right, you can lift her hands and you're going to cut out a little piece. Enough for your mouth to hold, but enough to share. She not letting go her husband at all. And Mr. Rodney is playing with the cake first. That's good. Play first is always good. Is what's so funny down here, sir? And he's taking his time to ensure that the cake is properly cut. And he's looking for the best piece of the cake. And he's measuring and sizing up the knife. And he's under. And it's up. And he's going to put it on this awesome crystal platter. Easy does it. Now, Mr. Rodney, you're going to be feeding your wife in the most intimate, passionate boy. He tell me something if I worry myself. Him got this. Let me stop it nice. Let's see if him got it. No man, you have to take up and big up. That can't share for you and her. I the kiss your auntie, no, it's not the cake. You see you?
I hear that house, you know. So, well, take care of me from the first. Let me take care of myself after.
But may want your feed her. All right, feed her, feed her, feed her. Me not in that house, sir. Feed her. Take care of the house. No, man, thank you.
Take care of your house first. Make sure your house all right. No problem in your house. You take care of yourself after.
From this moment, so let me feel, give him the mic and go sit down.
What I want to give me now, love share still. So me take care of us, them all share for me too.
All right. Right beside you is where I believe. Watch them. Watch them. No, sir. Of all Nerissa's cake-eating years, me not think she ever taste none taste so good. Watch her. She can't even hold up her head, the cake's sweet. Oh, my God. You have a decent husband. You realize what he said? He's going to feed you twice. He fed his house first. On her own, he fed her. And then when he took the piece that belonged to him, he didn't keep it to himself. He fed her again. A good husband, don't. Him ready. He's ready. He is ready. Now, Miss Nerissa, that's how your husband go about things, right? He takes care of home one time and two time, and yeah, he's a good man. He's a good husband. Now, I want to see what you as the wife have up your sleeve in how you plan to take care of your good, decent, God-sent husband. I'm already cut the cake, so that's not a worry.
I promise you this,
she'd make sure to take the piece with the icing. She have style.
From this
moment. All right, watch this now. Mm-hmm. 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 No matter, enough is stopping it. No mind me. Me just there for it, nice. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's your night. It's their night. Clap them, no man. It's their night. Enjoy it. Enjoy it. And it look like if me leave it up to them, they eat up the whole cake. It's a good thing we get food when we just come. Because if it was up to them, all of this would be done through the bird feeding and we don't get none. But clap them again. Watch love. Is this the moment? No. Okay. They want to eat. Go straight ahead. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the lovely couple will make their way back. Give them something nice while he seats his wife. Tip up our dress and them look at something there. Set it good. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right.
Looks like we made it. Look how far we've come, my baby.
All right. So as they are going to partake of this lovely meal,
we knew we'd get there someday.
We are going to be taking the toast. And the first toast of the evening goes to the lovely bride, Mrs. Campbell Rodney. And this will be done by no other than Annette Powell. Is Annette ready? Is Annette here? All right, clap Miss Powell as she makes her way to the table. All right. Blessed night to you all. As I come to you tonight, I just want to
greet my dear friend, a sister, and a very, very, very intrigued and intelligent young lady, Miss Nerissa Campbell Rodney. She has been a friend to me for 14 years, and she has never let me down. She always stands by my side. No matter how the situation is, she's always there for me. Whenever I'm sick, she's there. Always calling, always checking up. And I just want to tell her that I love her. I love her so much. And this very blessed occasion where the Lord is in the midst of the house, blessing her with a wonderful gentleman. I also know him over the years, and he has never let me down either, because he has always been by her side. And I know that the Lord is going to bless them in a very special way, right? And I know that this event is not just marriage on earth, but marriage in heaven. She's heavenly filled and heavenly blessed by this moment. So I just want you to all put your glass up and cheer her on this very blessed occasion. To Nerissa Campbell Rodney, I give the Lord thanks for everything, to show you that you are not just only a gem, but a beautiful queen in his eyes. So this day is your day. Thank you for your friendship. So I give the Lord thanks for you. All right?
Can we raise our glasses? Oh, you don't have any glass? All right. When I say cheers to, you're going to say love. Cheers to?
Love.
Cheers to?
Love.
All right. We don't have no glasses. Gone were the days we would mash up people glass and use fork and beat glass top and all them look at something there. But sometimes we have to just work with what we have. We have our voices. Cheers to? Amen, brothers and sisters. All right, so moving nicely along, we're going to be taking our other toast for this afternoon, or for this evening rather. And that toast will be done to the groom, the lovely groom, her God-sent knight in shining armor groom. And this toast will be done by no other than Mr. Garrett Armstrong. Can you make him feel welcome as he makes his way to the microphone?
Tell you how
keep the claps going until he arrives. So I'm feeling encouraged to be up here.
You have come and it's changed my whole world. Bye bye, sadness. Hello, man.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, my name is Garrett Armstrong. And I just like to say thanks to Mr. Rodney and Mrs. Rodney. Mrs. Rodney, the first time I met her was at night. I was going home, and I see I was walking on the street, and I stop and I said, "Hi, how far are you going?" She said, "I'm going by bus." I said, "Oh my God, come on in." That's the first time I saw her. And that's it for the night. I was saying thanks to Mrs. Rodney to make my friend a wonderful husband. Yes, and Mr. Rodney, you got a perfect wife. And I hope God may continue to bless you and keep you right through your relationship. Thank you.
All right. Now, it's so like the best man was the matchmaker, if I'm following the story well. Is that so? Is that what happened, Mr. Rodney? The best man introduced you to the lovely lady city that you are? Lord, Mike, husband won't talk. Tell a story when I liar.
Well, he helped encourage me. I said, she had the warnings, all right? She had one nice lady. So just continue what you're supposed to do, and everything will work out smooth.
Why me like the husband here, see, you just know if it's about everything. Oh my gosh. And know that the thank you clap they get. Clap him better than that, man. So Mr. Garrett Armstrong, you have a very vital role. So I see you have earned your position as the best man tonight because he was the one who made the connection. Is that so? All right. Now, moving right along, we are going to be taking another toast to the bride's parents, and this will be done by Ariel Bullock. Is that person here? Oh, she's here. My lovely friend down the back who sung her heart out. Remind me to tell the server that you should get 3 food here. Yes, and because the necklace is so nice, we can add 2 more to it, so 5 food.
She deserves it.
Okay, what can I say about Mummy? Mummy is the most encouraging mother you can have. She's there when you need her. She's there as a friend. She's there as a counselor. She raised 3 lovely girls. And tonight, we're celebrating the product of your work, Mummy. You are a great mother. You are a great confidant. And without you guiding me, sir, through all the ups and downs, Romaine would not have a wonderful bride tonight. So tonight is partially because of you. So let's raise our glasses. So, Mummy, Christine Smith.
I told you about mothers. There was this time when I was watching this this clip on social media, and they were advertising a job. And the job description, it was very similar to what I had mentioned. And it said the person must be, a lot of persons applied before they knew the description of the job. And it said things like, the person must be willing to work, standing all or most of the time. The person must be able to have or demonstrate high level of stamina, can be able to work 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And the more people were listening to the job description, it's like they were getting discouraged. Like they must say, no man, but this work not seem legal. And it went on to say, you cannot take no break. You only get lunch if the client gives you a chance to have lunch. And the applicants were saying, is this even right? And the interviewer, he said, lunchtime is only when the client decides, if they allow it. You must have a degree in medicine, finance, counseling, culinary arts, and the list went on. And the person said, but those don't mix. And the interviewer said, yes, this job is a real job. It is a reality. And nope, you know the ad. And it said, with this job, you must be able to wear several hats, must have high tolerance, put the client above yourself, and work through the night in a chaotic environment, and on and on. And the person said, so how much is the salary? And the interviewer said, unfortunately, you don't really get paid. And the person was like, you must be crazy, because this job isn't real. And the interviewer said, yes, it actually is. You have thousands of persons who actually carry out this job on a daily basis. And she said, like, who in their right mind does this type of job? And the interviewer said, mothers. All the mothers clap on themselves. And I'm sure I can attest to the fact that my nice Aunt Nelly is also an awesome mom, right? Just like all the other mothers. So we have a good mother for the groom, and we have a wonderful mother for the wife. Perfect couple. Perfect couple. All right, we're going down nicely. Now we have the toast that is to be given to the groom's parents, and this will be done by Miss Winifred Studdart. If you are from my country where I'm, everybody knows this lady. Everybody knows her.
So clap her, no? Like when you know her too. Yes, man, clap her.
Thank you very much, Miss Master of Ceremony. And if you were listening, you would have heard many times I've gone to weddings and they say Master of Ceremonies. But she didn't put no hess on it. She said Master of Ceremony. To our host and hostess, Mr. and Mrs. Romaine Rodney, the newly wed. And I like it. I love it. And I am here to speak on behalf of one lady. And that lady is Eugenie Mama Nelly Hunter. But I must tell you something, that I am from the very beautiful community of Wimps Road, where everybody is our brothers and sisters keeper. And not only that, but every child is our own children. And let me tell you something. Mama Nelly has been my friend for over half a century. And that time it was called best friend. But we changed the status quo now, and it is called Bessie. And she doesn't live in Jamaica anymore. She now lives overseas. But let me tell you something. Nobody can say anything about Mama Nelly and make me hear, else me phone, do something. That's the kind of friendship that we share. And the same goes for her when she was in Jamaica. I was very much protected. Mama Nelly is a wonderful mother. And let me stress that. She have no pitney, but she take care of everyone. And let me tell you something. The handsome groom this evening is Mama Nelly's second to last child. And they lost their father, who they lost many, many years when they were small children. And their father's name was Nathaniel Rodney. But Mama Nelly didn't drop the responsibility. She run with it. She take it up and she run with it. And this evening, all of them has grown to be very good men and women. And I must tell you that Mama Nelly is the kind of person that if you work with her, she will work with you. But if you don't work with her, dog, nyam, you supper. Because she's a no-nonsense person. That's my friend, Mama Nelly. And this evening, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell Mrs. Rodney, Mrs. Rodney, now that you have Mama Nelly's son, and she is your mother-in-law, she will give you her support. And if her son wrong, she not say right. She's not going to say it's right. She's not going to say Evan is right. So Evan, my mouth loud, and we can't talk. Evan, better buckle up. Because if you no buckle up, well, you buckle down. See there?
in buckle, you see it? In buckle up. So. Evan knows what he has to do. And he knows that his task is there for him to perform. So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, those that have a glass and those that do not have a glass, lift them high as we propose a toast to Eugenie Mama Nelly Hunter. Long life to her and prosperity, as we say this evening. Thank you.
My dreams, I hope that someday I'll share her home.
Thank you so much to Miss Stoddart. And I want to tell you that if you're getting married and you don't have anybody to do toast, you can just link her. She have this type of thing governed. She sound like she know what she's doing, right? Well said. The bride said to tell you that she's anxious. And even though we are the onlookers and we do have a program, they call the shots. You agree with them? It's their night, right? Now this beautiful lady who is seated to my right, who is the woman of the hour, she has something up her sleeve, a surprise, for her dear husband that she wants to show all of you. This part you can see. And so, she had asked that I give her the mic so she can serenade her husband. Her husband is eating, but would I like if you like put him up there so, and him ready, you know, oh God, him cooperative, so till. Come up to the front, man. Come and declare your love. It's your night. We're not stopping you. Just put it at the front of the table so she can use up her space wisely. It's your Sharon. She needs space. Come. Does he need to take off his jacket? I don't know if you're going to light some type of fire and we don't want him to burn up and so. He can keep his jacket on? All right. Thank you.
That was simply amazing. I enjoyed it. And to how you enjoy it, you know, in a shock, you can't have a clap. But I'm going to bring it back to reality now and ask you to clap, please. Clap them. She had tears in her eyes. And if you can't feel it, there's a song that says, "Can you feel the love? Me go make you get more food. Tonight, I can feel the love tonight. Can you feel the love tonight? I certainly can feel it. I've been observing this beautiful couple all day. And trust me, you can see that there is a sincere, genuine type of love that is being shared between both Mr. and Mrs. Rodney. It is not a show for you, me sure. Because I've been to weddings before. Me go to a whole heap of wedding. And they have to be forcing them to kiss. You ever go on one of them the wedding there before? Kiss man, kiss. Them? You don't have to tell them. Them just want your love. And even before you say, Rodney start kiss Mrs. Rodney long time, so we are late. Watch love. Cheers to, love. Now, Mr. Rodney is a very special man because not every groom gets a wife that can sing. Talk about that part. Not true. You have enough good wife, them can cook and other things. But when you find when we can't sing, oh gosh, Mr. Rodney now go and go to work daytime. By the time she feel wake you up with a song, you spend the whole day at home. And little before you know it, you have to get all these wonderful, stunningly attired bridesmaids and line them up on days of the week to turn babysitter. You think it's a love go? You just go and love, 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 and then nothing don't come after that? You better take names. You're going to need babysitters. Because love come with? All right, somebody knows. The five most essential words for a healthy and vital relationship, they say, are, I bet you couldn't tell me. The five most essential words for a healthy and vital relationship are, Mr. Rodney, you know them? What are the five most essential words for a healthy relationship? I'm going to tell you tonight. You're going to pay me later though. They are, I apologize. That's the first two. You want to guess the other three? I apologize is the first one. I am sorry. Close enough. That's one word. We're looking for three. Yes. I love you. No, sir. No, the one there at all. Keep it vital.
I apologize, and let me start it for you. You are right. You see how simple that is? A lot of us find it hard to say we are sorry. But in relationships like this, when it is legal and God is in the midst, if you want it healthy and vital, it is recommended that you practice those 5 words. I apologize, and you are right. Missy Bunting, I take notes. You know, watch him. Watch him, I take notes. He hide the pen as me call his name. And then, you know the truth about it? Trevor, go on like he now listen, you know. You know them people will look a bush, but them a listen? Trevor. Eh? What you say, Mr. Dancer? You better not. Now, there was this wife. While we make way for the other toast, we have the toast to the groomsmen. But while Miss Radisha finishes up her meal, a wife said to her husband, she looked across her neighbor's fence. There are a lot of times when we as people or as couple, we watch other people and see what they do. It's lie or it's true. And we often tend to say, so how my husband nah do that or how my wife nah do that, don't it? Yes? But it is normally encouraged to, as Mrs. Rodney said, hold your head straight. Now a wife looked over her neighbor's house and she says, I notice our neighbor, the male she's talking, I notice our neighbor always kisses his wife when he leaves for work. And she turned to her husband and say, why don't you do that? And the husband's reply was, how can I do that when I don't even know her? Joke went over your head. Me say it again. Wife looked over her neighbor's house and she saw the husband kissing the wife and she said to her husband, why don't you do that? And the husband's reply was, how can I kiss her when I don't even know her? Miss DeMar, because she's fasting over her neighbor and we want to encourage them to spend a little time sometimes, and this is for everybody, spend a little time on your own thing. Not true? All right, and now watch the crowd. Now we're getting ready for the next toast, and our next toast is a toast to these awesome men, dapperly dressed in gray suits. Can they stand and we take a second look? Men, I know the belly kind of bulge out now because your belly full, but tuck it in. You don't have to tuck in nothing. One pack, my cousin said one pack. And if she like you, the belly don't matter, don't it? Well, all right, the belt is big enough. So we have 3 awesome gentlemen, and we don't see them very often dressing this dapperly. But we have a young lady who comes to us in the form of Mrs. Radisha Spence-Sterling, who is going to be rendering a toast to these 3 awesome men. As she makes her way to the microphone, can you make her feel welcome, please, and thank you. Me have to make sure they soon, you know.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. All right, I am Radisha, and I am toasting the groomsmen and the best man. All right, so I'm going to do the best man first because I'm saving the best for last. All right, so I know Long. He's like a very jovial person, and once you're around him, he's going to say something positive, he's going to give you a joke. Then to Bunting now. Not many persons can say this, but God has blessed me with some awesome uncles. Like, I'm telling you, they're not only uncles, but they're like father figures to me. Bunting, for one, there is not a day that I don't. If I pick up my phone and call Bunting, he's going to answer. And he's a person where I can reason with, not only on the level of an uncle, but on the level of a friend. Yes, and it's not only now, from I was little. I can tell Bunting anything. And mommy now go hear back, daddy now go hear back, everyone now go hear back, nobody now go hear back. Right? And I don't want any one of my uncles otherwise to feel any type of way. But if me rich a morning, Bunting a fi rich. Straight. To Uncle Cheva now. Uncle Cheva is the type of uncle. If he hears anything about you, don't believe, say. He might go run and say, Maxine, you know, say, this Ruddy, I'm the first person he's going to come to. Right? And if I am wrong, he's not going to pretty it up and say, oh, Ramesh, you know that. You shouldn't burst the boy head, you know. You know, if you burst the boy head, and you know, say you're wrong. That's what I like about Uncle Cheva. Uncle Cheva is the type of uncle that you can send in a shop and you buy a chichi for that money and you know, go first. Yes. So I am blessed, beyond blessed, to have awesome uncles, right? All right, then I'm going to start off with the open toast, right? So I'm going to toast the bride and the groom. So Mr. and Mrs. Rodney. But they not look for me. But they not look for me. Me talk to you now. Me talk to you now. And me not go pretty up now. Right? Marriage. It's very serious. When I tell her, say, serious. It's serious like when me did liquor and used to serious. That is how serious marriage is. And you see, anybody, no make nobody tell us, say, marriage easy. It's not easy. It's a journey that, me tell her, say, sometimes the only thing I'm going to need is a boxing ring and two boxing gloves. Right? Me tell her, it's not easy. And you see, when the devil ready for step in, he will step in, but you see them? Don't afraid to go down upon your knees. You hear me tell you no? Not afraid to go down upon your knees. I can feel like you can't go upon your knees. Stand upon your foot and tell the devil, say, listen, not my marriage, not my husband, not my wife. Right? My grandparents that was married for 60 odd years, or almost 60 years. You know what them tell me, say? Marriage consists of three persons. The husband, the wife, and God in the midst. So you see, when you hear he say, she said, them say, go ask your husband, go ask your wife. And I know every day we're not going to love each other. But every day is days where you're going to stay committed to each other. So when you get up and you feel like you're not loving today, make sure, say, yes, when I step out, you are a wife. And I tell her this morning, I'm going to tell her in front of everybody, you are being promoted. You're not a girlfriend anymore. You're a wife. So you're going to be a wife. And I did not lose an uncle. I gained an aunt. Good night. Good night. MC.
With that said, who can come and counteract? That was a very intense and intimate and personal toast. Is it a good thing that she knows you that well? Is it a good thing when somebody knows you that well? Yes, I would agree. And we mustn't wait until it is a sorrowful event to talk the things about people, don't it? Because a lot of times the only time you hear something good about somebody is when they can't hear it for themselves. They're laying flat in a 4x4 structure. We don't want to use that word. No negative energy tonight. Clap her once again. Wonderful, Radisha. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we have toasted the groomsmen. We have toasted the bride and groom. And there is one set of persons who are yet to be toasted. I'm assuming that they have left these bevies of beauty for last for a particular reason. And so at this time, and I want you to clap this person who is coming. He goes by the name of Mr. Dwight Otte. When you clap him good, 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 then I'll tell you why you had to clap him so good. Let us welcome Mr. Otte as he's going to be taking on the task of toasting these gorgeous ladies seated at the head table. The bride's left hand. Me can't say right, gonna sit down on the left. So the bride's left hand.
Thank you so much, Madam Master of Ceremony, and good evening, everyone. The task and pleasure is mine to give a toast to the bridesmaid and the maid of honor. I saw them today for the first time, and I said, let me see how these ladies are. And they are graceful. They are happy. They are radiant. They add so much flair and flavor to this wedding in how they escorted their partners, their groomsmen, and how they honor the bride tonight. And I want you, ladies and gentlemen, to give your hands, put your hands together for these three beautiful ladies. Clap them. In particular, the bride's sister. Is that Mrs. Marissa Campbell Brown? Oh, yes. And she sang so gracefully, and she seems happy tonight. And thank you for letting us have a lovely night and for blessing your sister and complimenting your sister on this wonderful night. So to the bridesmaid and to the maid of honor, it was a pleasure to have you tonight, to let tonight be a beautiful night and to celebrate with the Rodneys. Thank you so much.
I'm going to ask that you clap him better than that. And you see, worse like how to eat up the food already. I know there's strength in the hands. Thank you so much, Mr. Otte. He came on the whim of the moment because the person who was originally supposed to do it was unavailable, and I just called on him, and he did an excellent job. Clap him one more time. Thank you so, so much, Sir Otte. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're moving nicely along. And at this time, we're asking any person who wishes to come and share their own well wishes. It is not slated on the program, but you feel that urgent desire or that need to come and say your own congratulations in your own way. And I see Mr. Dean Worth scratching his leg. And I think he's searching for that paper that he wrote something on. Anybody? Somebody? There's a prize to be won, you know. And no other love will do. That's why I love you. All right, there's a... While Trevor gets ready, there's a lady competing with me. Eh? Yeah? There's a lady who sits to my left, and she has been fully supporting me all night. Everything I say, she claps, and she's very much keen with her attention. And I appreciate that about her. If everybody was like her tonight, it would be such a cheerful room. She's a cut above the rest. Let me encourage her if you talk no matter. And so, even though I don't have her name, but I can cite her beautiful face and her lovely attire, she does stand out. And if you know me, very well, anybody know me, I love the senior folks. I just have a genuine passion for persons who are older than me. See my grandmother there? Love her bad. Bad, 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 bad. You're my grandmother too. Yes. Yes. You and Buster cook it up and you're now playing like you don't know it's you. But he told me that you speak very eloquently. You speak very well. He said to me, just the way you dress, it's the same way you speak. And if you speak like you dress, if you ever speak like you dress. CMT, she's ready. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give her a round of applause as she's about to add her own well wishes.
There goes my hand shake.
Oh, let me stop. Right.
She can't sing?
My heart keeps bleeding. I need you. If I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, put your hands together. Let's give God thanks tonight because it is night. Amen. This is twilight wedding. We bless God. We honor him. We worship him. We give him thanks. Amen. God is a good God. And when I look around and see just two individuals, look at the crowd that he brought. Mr. and Mistress Rodney. Buster. Babes. Babes. Yes, I came in contact with this goodly gentleman. If you notice, I have. I walk with a stick. When I couldn't get a ride to go to church, I am from St. James, Moore Park, and I go to church in Trelawney, Bunkers Hill. And I can remember the first time he carries me, it was another driver that asked him to pick me up. He does. He was an on-time man. If you notice, I said was. An on-time man. I'm not saying that he's not now. But because of the persons over that table, too, started getting late. So he started coming late. And we traveled with him. I think it's from 2016, 17, thereabout. Yes. That's how long. Mm-hmm. This is Sister Chubby. When I came in this evening, I heard somebody say, who is Sister Chubby? I said, me. And he said, I always hear Buster talk about you. Buster. Mm-hmm. That's what I called him, Buster. Buster, where you are? Buster, you're coming. This gentleman never said no to me. Never. Is always there. Anything I can call him, ask him to do. I can call him from my home. I said, where you are? In Montego Bay. I said, go round such a street. I'm going to call the lady. The lady going to meet you. And you pick up something and care for me. And he pick it up. And he knows that I can't manage to come up the gate. And he come out of the bus, shut in door. Run, come down on my house. That's Buster. Yes. It was last night I was saying to somebody, I remember when I have a elderly lady at my home, no relative, just church sister. I said, Buster, come care Miss Cummings to doctor for me. And he was very much there. And when he came back, there was nobody there to help him. He's a little lady, not big like me. Buster said, go on, Sister Chubby. Open up the door. And when you open, I will come.
and then lift up the lady and take her right inside the room. I mean, I have to tell my pastor. I'm talking about a young man. I love his energy. And out of the young man, there comes Sister Nair. Mm-hmm. And I always admire them, not only tonight. They look beautiful. Yes, I love the orange and the black. I'm sort of a long meter, but I go and cut it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man, ask them, I'm sort of a long meter. They are a beautiful couple. Buster always look after me. If somebody come in the front, because him know I don't sit in the back, he asks them to sit around here, so become he come in. A girlfriend of mine once heard me talk about Buster. And when Buster take us to church, because he takes me to church every Sunday morning. But sister come to me and say, me have you go down and go see a who named Buster. And he go down and go see. He say, oh, who are you? Yeah, man. Brethren and friends, when you come across people like these, you must treasure them. You must love them. You must take care of them. You must pray for them that God will keep them together. I have a book at home where it said, keep the devil out of your marriage. Trample your foot and tell him, say, not tonight. Open the door, glory to God, and send him out of your house. Send him out of your life, glory. There will be somebody coming. Don't listen to everything, my brother. Sisterin, don't listen to everything. No, make no girlfriend come here. Some don't mix with me. No, make no girlfriend come on your yard and tell you nothing. Say, Missy Buster down a road. Make him stay down there. Make him stay down a road. Yes, man. Because you're not married a dopey. Look at how he's handsome. A very handsome young man. I bless God for you tonight. And sir, not because you're tired enough, no. Nobody forget if you come pick me up. And long, I thank God for him also. Him almost be my son-in-law. Almost. Mm-hmm. But he went, there you go. And I'm ugly, I'm slow, it's slow. He went too slow. But he almost be my son-in-law. I thank God for all of you tonight. Mama, God bless you. Mamas, two mamas. God bless you. God bless you. You raised two beautiful, beautiful souls. And let me pray for them. I'm a mother of two biological, but whole heap. Whole heap of them. Mm-hmm. So we got to pray for them. Amen? And beautiful, why? Look at them. One, put up your hand. Put up your left hand, let me see it. Put up yours. Left. Put up yours. Huh? Oh, you're married. So you wear your ring. Keep them off. Yeah, man. As they come up, you say, I am married. Mm-hmm. Sister Nerissa can say that. I am taken. Yes, I am taken. And I don't know much about these young men, if they are taken. But young man, if you are taken, put with you. God bless you. Mr. Photographer, let me say thank you. Mr. Music Man, thank you. Thank you for the food. Thank you for the food. But one thing, and I will mention it tonight. God bless you. You take care. Amen. Praise God.
After such an awesome speech, I'm going to ask that you give her a better response than that.
I was listening keenly because me like when the elderly folks talk, you get a lot of wisdom because they talk from a place of experience. All right? And if you know me well, my father's name is Clinton Hines, and if you know him good, he's a man who loves humor. So genetically, me get some of the humor. Put it that way. It's the right father me get. Two are we nice alike. Mm-hmm. Now, I was listening to the speech, but I was then trying to figure out, how is it you have a buster and a chubby? Being so close of friends, it was meant to be. It was intentional. It's not no mere coincidence. It's like it's God plans to make a friendship between a chubby and a buster. Anybody in here drink chubby and buster? The two of them is what you call it again? What's the fancy term? The scientific term? Carbonated beverages, and always so bubbly. And I would say tonight, if you agree with me, you cannot, that Sister Chubby, as slowly as she walks, I can sense her bubbly personality. I think so. And Buster, in his own right, Mrs. Buster, don't worry. The frizz and the thing is coming over to you. And Buster, in his own right, is also a bubbly person. Is that so? So it's no coincidence that they are friends because of the similar personalities of bubbly. Ladies and gentlemen, we have just concluded the open toast because as I can see from where I'm standing, we have the lovely cameraman. What is wrong with Trevor? Making up his face and all these things because he well want Junior talk. What make you not come talk, Trevor? Cha. All right. So we're going to ask Mr. Junior, who is the brother of our groom, the man of the moment, to come and offer his own well wishes to the newlyweds. And I was told that when he speaks for everybody, because Trevor told me that he is the head. And we are people who embrace the head. So Mr. Head, Mr. Salmon, please come and make your way to the microphone. And as he comes, allow him to feel welcome.
Thank you. Well, Miss Chubby already said it. I'm just going to just connect to it. So I'm here for support by congratulations to you all. I'm just put it in one, because you are one right now. So I just here to just congratulate you. It's a journey. We are different people. We do different, we speak different. So we just have to have understanding with each other. Bye. Sorry. So as I say, it's a journey. I'm 27 years in marriage, and I'm congratulate Buster, just start, and Nareen. I've met you just a few times, but you're my sister, and congratulations to you. Thank you.
And I must apologize for that interruption, sir. I was trying to get things flowing, so when you were finished, we were ready. All right. So thank you to Big Brother, Mr. Junior himself, flew all the way from over the waters just to share in this memorable moment. And of course, your presence is highly appreciated, sir. And you're doing an excellent job with all the work I've been seeing you doing from night. It has not gone unseen. From I've been here, we all see him working, right? He's a very helpful big brother, and I'm sure we can all say yes to that. All right. So we're going to invite the lovely couple to make their way to the forefront of the table once again, as they are going to be participating in a little activity to show us how well they know each other. Now you'll be removing both your shoes, and we're going to see if they can seal off the marriage with how well they know each other. They are not strangers. We don't expect them to be, but they're gonna prove to us tonight that they're not strangers. I'm sure they didn't meet out by the gate and decided to go to the church today. All right, they're drinking. We're gonna take the chairs back to back. We're gonna get a nice little jazzy song, Just the Way You Are, Bruno Mars. Can we get that one? DJ Chin, Just the Way You Are, Bruno Mars, as they make their entrance. All right, so you're gonna seat your wife, sir. You can put her here, sure, if that's where she wants to sit. And you're going to take your seat. Now you're going to take off both your shoes. She's going to take off both her shoes as well. Now you're going to keep one foot and you're going to give her one. Her maid of honor, could you assist her with her shoes, please? Because probably it's a little hard for her to bend. It's so sad to think that she don't see what I see. But every time she asks me, do I look okay? I say, when I see your this game is called How Well Do You Know Your Partner? Now, if I ask a question and you think that the person who fits the answers best is your wife, then you put up your wife's shoes. And if you think the question is speaking to you, then you put up your own shoes. Now, this is the only time in the marriage when you can't consult her. There's no consultation. You're speaking freely tonight. You can wrestle it out after you go home, but you're going to hold both shoes in your hand, Mr. Rodney. Mrs. Rodney is ready. And as I ask these questions, you're going to tell me which one of you best fit each description or the question. And we want honest answers only. Let's see how well they know each other. You ready? Man, you know, so like the food, giving a nigga rightness and all these things. Are you ready? All right. If you're ready, say, cheers to love. Who made the first move? Who first approached who? You have to keep it up, me we see where they go on, man. All right? Mm-hmm. Who paid on the first date? All right. A good man, man. Mm-mm. Who was the first to declare their love? Who first said, I love you? Who first? Mix up. Mix up. Or you have convenient memory. Who proposed? All right. She's a good girl. She know the runnings. Who's more romantic? All right. Now you know the root of where the kissing is coming from. Who plans more elaborate date night? Who wants to do all the fancy stuff and go out and enjoy each other's company? Who initiates the dates? Listen to me. I don't know. Simple lift up and go on around the side, you know. A style and all these wind up and wiggle up something. All right. Now, this is a very sensitive one. Listen carefully now. Who wears the pants in the relationship? Who wears the pants? Who call the shots? All right. Submissive wife is good. My next question. Who is the better kisser? Who kissed the best? Mix up again. Next, who is more likely to talk their way out of a speeding ticket? Who know if we get away from murder? Can talk to save themselves. All right, man of mouth. It better because they say women love to hear things. Who is better when it comes to directions? Can direct properly. All right. How they doing so far? They doing good? They know each other well? They deserve to be married? I agree. Who is the best chef? Who can cook the most scrumptious meals? Lord, hello. Is it Sunday when you're cooking? Call me. I'm going to leave my number over there, sir. Who is more likely to steal all the covers on a cold night? You know some partner sleep with them, you can't ever get piece of the sheet. Who is more to steal the covers? Them one wire wrap up in a sheet. Watch out. All right. This one you have to learn to tolerate after tonight moving forward. Who snores louder? You see how quick the hand go up? Oh, my God. All right. Who wakes up first? Who is the early riser? It look like somebody wake up while somebody's still asleep. Huh? Who stays up later? Last to go to bed. Okay. All right. Who spends more time staring at their phone? A bad habit that most of us have. Write this down because you may need to tell her that have to stop after tonight. Your phone is now sitting on the chair behind you. That's where you're going to stare. Who's more likely to start an argument? First one, head hot. Hold it up, man. You see how quick she put it up and take it down? Hold it up. Hold it up. Yes, man. Hold it up. Honesty is the best policy. Who is more likely to apologize after an argument? Oh, she just remembered something. She just woke up it quick, you see? Watch her. Who is more likely to max out their credit card? The big spender. Who loves to spend? All right. Mm-hmm. Look like you're getting help over there, so Mr. Rodney. All right. Who is more likely to save all their money? Who is the miser? Save more than you spend. Okay, sir. Mr. Choice of Words, choose your words wisely. That's what he's telling me. All right. Who is more dramatic? The first one to cause a scene. More dramatic. Mr. Rodney, stretch out the shoes forward first. Like him, I wonder if he'd be honest about that one. All right, moving on. Who is more stubborn? Stubborn. My way. And you're getting support over there, so. Most of the time. Hey, put up your shoes. Hey, sometime, most time, it's still stubborn. Solve it before the. So you're a problem solver. You're a good man. You're a good man. And you just forget all about it. You're a good man, man. No wonder you're sitting in that chair tonight. Yeah, man, he's a good boy. Who is more organized? The planner, more organized. Boy, if every man were organized, the world would be a better place, don't it? You hardly find an organized man. It's normally the wife doing the organizing. And you found yourself an organized man, Mrs. Rodney? Oh my gosh, you are blessed. Very blessed. Who is more athletic? If a fire should start tonight, first through the door. All right. We call that perfect match, right? All right. Who is better at keeping secrets? Who for secret are keeping? Both of us? All right. Who would last longer on a deserted island? This person knows how to survive. With or without nothing. Me know you're a good man, you know. Oh, my God. Very good man. Who is more outgoing? Big personality. The social butterfly. Smile and pleasant. I can see that. You ever see some people and just by the look of their face, they look so welcoming, so sociable. When I look at her, I see that. She doesn't even have to speak. You know that she's a very welcoming person and sociable. Good going, Nerissa. Who is more likely to cry during a sad movie? She's emotional. She can be very emotional. All right. So if you haven't bought a gift yet, they're going to need some towels. All right. Who is a better dancer? All right. I can see that. I saw the entrance and she was dancing. All right. And at one point I saw you looking like, Lord, Nerissa, take time now. But we saw. You have to go get some weights because she's going to be dropping it like it's hot. Who gives a better massage? Who gives a better massage? Ner, how you know about Ner and her massage? What is happening here? Hold on. Who is this little man over here, sir? He's your son? He's Evan's son? It's Ner's son and Evan's son. And he knows that nurse give a good massage. What is this, Lord? Jesus, take the wheel. Take it from his hands. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure that we enjoy that activity. We're going to allow them to put their shoes on. And at this time, we're going to ask, since they're at the forefront, to go ahead and do their first, is there a song that you have in mind that you wanted to dance to? Me no scenery, so I want to dance to wife, you are the wife, and whatever. But I think we're going to tone it down now. She shake her head and say no. Is there a song that was selected for the couple's dance? Pardon? All right, just put your shoes back on. You can put yours on and go assist your bride. And then you're going to do your couple's dance, all right? Yeah, man, let's put on your shoes and you can help her put on her own.
Because you know I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no.
am not sure if the person who knows where the light switch are is standing anywhere close. Is that person here? Who is responsible for the light switch? Anybody knows? There's a man on the outside. We wanted to dim the lights a bit. Is anyone coming forward? Can somebody identify who is the person responsible for the lighting? Awesome. You see, he's a good man. He even knows where the light is. Look at that. Sure. Now, if you'd agree with me that with these pepper lights, that the tone has been set a little more intimate and a little bit more romantic. And at this time, the couple will be sharing with us their first dance, apart from the wife, their first dance, because Nerissa wastes the weight power. Mm-hmm. And they will be dancing for us at this point in time. And I've selected a lovely song for you. If you have your phone lights, you can just take them out and give them a wave. You can take out your phone light.
I found love.
Your camera lights.
In you.
And give them a wave.
And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. And no other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away. Forever and a while, in my heart is where you'll stay. And this is why I love you. Ooh, this is why. Have all aligned, and right now is the perfect time to say, I love you, 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 I do.
Love, 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 love.
fell love in you. And no other love will do. That's why I love you. What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head spinning.
Can you give them a round of applause? That was so sensual. No, not go too far. Don't go far. You're going to sit at the front. It's not time for the garter and the bouquet, and we go wrap up quickly. Are you nice?